What's up, everybody? This is Carolina Mike, your host for SharePoint in 60 Seconds, the channel where you can get the information you need in the first 60 seconds. And if you want to hear all the gory details, then stick around. Today, we're going to talk about what's the difference between SharePoint site pages, wiki pages, and web part pages. Stick around. I'm a SharePoint expert, play with data extra. Careful with my hands because I got to use them for work. Yeah, I'm a big old nerd. I like maple syrup on my pancakes. I don't care what you heard. Okay, before we get started, please go ahead and hit that like and subscribe. Please share with someone who you think might be able to find some value. Thank you to all of my subscribers. I appreciate you. We are one step away from being a monetized channel, and it's because of you. Thank you. Okay, let's bring the timer out. Here we go. Difference between SharePoint web part pages, wiki pages, and site pages. Let's start with the old school first. Web part pages. First thing was around like 2003, 2007. Very rigid. You can't do freeform text. Everything's a web part. Very rigid. Next, moving up in modernality. Not a real word, but I'm making it a word. Next up, we have the wiki page. This opened up a whole new world. Freeform, kind of, to a certain extent. Yeah, freeform and plus web parts. Then you step it really up to interactive pages, and we call them site pages, and those things are just the bomb. You get the best of all the worlds. They're super amazing. Freeform text, tables, graphics, oh, it's crazy. Okay, I don't know if that was 60 seconds or not, but let's go ahead and get into showing you a demo of each of those pages. We're going to start by going into site contents, and in site contents, we're going to take a look at the site pages document library. Yes, site pages is a document library. Well, it's a page library. Okay, fine. Page library. So we're going to go to site pages. In our site pages, first thing we got to do is make sure that we have the site content type enabled for web part pages if you want to see or play with them in real life. Why you don't want to do that, I don't know why you'd want to do it, because anything you could do with the web part page, you could do with a wiki page, and anything you can do with a wiki page, guess what you can do with a site page. So we'll just show you from the bottom to the top, top to the bottom. I'm going to rock them while I still got them. Only a few of us really got that reference, but here we go. So we got to go into the library settings and make sure that we enable the content type for web part page. So we can go in here. We can go to add from existing content types. And you're going to go in here and you're going to find the web part page and you're going to add it. Boom. All right, so and in order to be able to add the web part page, I believe you have to be in the site pages library and hitting the new drop down. So web part page, I don't even know why I'm creating one of these. I hope it doesn't break my tenant. You know what? I don't think I am. I'm just going to, you see how this, it's real rigid. So you pick the layout and then you pop stuff in the layout. I'm not even going to create one of these because they're just super old school. I'm sorry. All right, and then we have wiki pages. So we'll create a new wiki page. This one I might actually show you. All right, so crazy. Oh my gosh, I'm on the spot. I always like to say delete this because I know I don't need it. All right, yeah, create. See, it looks super archaic if you're used to site pages, but it is a bit more freeform. So that's the thing. Like with the web part page, you couldn't just start typing. You had to actually add a web part. Site pages kind of go back to that, but it's still way better. So don't worry about it. So this is that page. I guess I'll save it. I don't know why. I just, you know, if you got to do a lot of versioning and very rigid things, then web part pages and wiki pages could be for you. All right. Now let's go back to site contents and to the site pages library. And we're going to show you like the best of all worlds, which is the site page. These things are like web part pages and wiki pages on steroids. They're super amazing. No, you can't just freeform start typing. But, you know, it'll be okay. You got just so much stuff that you could do here. I think we'll do another video. If there's something in particular you want to see, any one of these web parts, let me know. We can do a video on it. But here's your, you know, the most basic web part is this. But, I mean, oh, it's just, it's amazing. So, there you go. Difference between web part pages, wiki pages, and site pages. old to new, web part page, super strict, very rigid, great for controlling things, but not very feature rich. A step up from that is your wiki. You do get some freeform text. You got to add the web parts, but it's not as robust as the site pages, which are the bee's knees. It's where you want to be. If you're creating a new page in SharePoint, you better be creating a site page. That's all I got to say. So this is Carolina Mike saying, take it easy. Please like and subscribe. Share with somebody you think might be able to have use of this or find value in it. Stay positive. Do the best you can with what you got. Keep smiling, and I'll see y'all next time. Take it easy, y'all. I'm a SharePoint expert. Play with data extra. Careful with my hands, because I got to use them for work. Yeah, I'm a big old nerd. I like maple syrup on my pancakes. I don't care what you heard.